Hi everybody, welcome to today's video. I am bringing you rummaging with me today. I found a neighborhood-wide rummage sale and some fun pieces. Many I didn't pick up, but I love rummaging because the deals are great and a lot of people at these sales were willing to bargain. So I'm gonna share that with you and then I'll have a fun vintage antique haul at the end. So I'm going to start with the decor pieces first. I found these two vintage blue ball ideal mason jars. One has the metal handle still on it and the other one does not. But these were 50 cents a piece. And so I have several larger ones of these and I decorate for the fall in blues, creams, whites, some brown, some mustard, like more neutrally color. And so I thought I could either decorate with these or try to sell them because 50 cents was a great deal for both of those. All right, this next picture, this piece is a 1975 Arner's picture, and I think I'm going to resell this. I'm not sure I really like all the detailing here, like kind of more simple plain pictures, as you can see back there on my shelf. And so I think I'm going to try to resell this either on eBay or Facebook Marketplace, but I got this for $1. The detail is really pretty. It doesn't really have much wrong with it at all, so I thought this would be something fun to try to resell, and who could not pass this up for $1. All right, this is my next decor piece. Again, $1. It had two on it. I asked for $1. Not sure if it had been used for cutting. I think so, and I probably just will use it more for decor. Again, I have a collection of some wood cutting boards, and I thought, why not add to it? I could hang it on a wall. I could add it to my stack of them that I have in my corner by my stove. So I thought that was a good find for $1. Okay, not so much for decor, but more practical. This was originally at $3. I got it for $1.50 because everything at that rummage was 50% off, or whatever they said I wanted, honestly. It was really fun to go to that one. It was the one with, well, I guess you saw me pick up the picnic basket and look at some vintage mirrors, like trays, that one. So this one was at that sale. And so I'll probably use it for either making sauerkraut. I need a bigger container for my sourdough starter. This is a little bit big for sourdough, but I'm pretty sure it's been used for food, actually. And I feel safe using these, and these online retail for quite a bit. So I'm okay finding it for $1.50. Okay, in the decor theme, kind of. This is a Chanel bedspread, and they said it would cover a full size, so I will probably just use it as like a coverlet on the end of my bed. It's got some really pretty detailing on it, some tassels and fringe on the end, and this was $7 originally, again at that same 50% off sale, so I got it for, I think, $3.50 is what I got it for, and I thought that would be really pretty, and it would work well for fall and the neutral colors, because you always need a little extra covering when the temperatures get a little bit cooler out. Again, same garage sale. This did not have a price on it, so they asked for $2, but for all those three items I just showed you, well, this is the third one, it was $6 for everything. So I love decorating with picnic baskets in the spring and summer, and so yes, I know I'll probably have to be waiting to put this out, but it's really cute on the inside with the blue liner. Or I could even use it over at our little fixer upper too. That could be an idea. But I thought it was just so adorable, and I have a stack of picnic baskets right now in my house decorating with those, and it's got really nothing wrong with it too much, I can see. It's very solid, very sturdy. So this was $2, I want to say. All right, kind of in the decor, this is a scarf. Now, it's really lightweight, but since I want to decorate for fall in the bluish white theme, like I said, this is kind of like, looks almost like jean material, but it's not. And so it was $1, and I'm really excited to have found this to hang it on my like peg rack, or to honestly wear it. It is multifaceted, and use it as a table decor. I mean, there's lots of options to use with lighter scarves, so really fun find, again, for just $1. Okay, I think that was most of my decor. I found this. We're going on a leaf hunt. I thought it'd be fun for fall for my 2-year-old daughter. It was actually free. Someone just had a table sitting out in their driveway with a bunch of free stuff. So I thought that would be kind of fun just to read through, teach her about different types of trees and their leaves. So fun little free book. My favorite find is this giant water bath canner. Now, a lot of you who follow my gardening and canning know that I just use a stock pot normally. This was $15. It's a brand new canner. It has some equipment inside as well, which was a bonus. It has the tongs to pull it out, and it has the metal rack in there. Just a few other things to help with the canning process. So I could not pass up $15 for a canner. I was so excited to find that. All right, kind of in the fall theme, but for clothing, I just found two things for me. Another pair of jeans. This had $4 on it originally, and I got it for $3. It's the Gap 1969 straight leg jean. And so I just, you know, I wear my jeans till they're pretty worn, and Post-pregnancy, again, I'm a different size than I was pre-pregnancy, actually a little bit smaller. So I'm needing some smaller pants to fit my body shape a little bit better. So I didn't try them on, so I thought $3 is okay for a pair of jeans, especially that are in such nice condition. And then I just found a Faded Glory gray sweater. I lost my other gray sweater, so it has pockets here. It is a little large, but oversized sweaters are, I think they're still kind of popular. I don't know. I do my own fashion. I don't follow the trends, but this was $1, and so I thought it'd be a really cute little cardigan to wear for the fall. And hey, it would probably work with that scarf. So that is my haul and my rummage with me. I know many of you do enjoy seeing what I get to see and seeing what I end up picking up. So give it a thumbs up if you do enjoy it, share it with your friends, and hopefully I'll be coming at you with another video later this week and maybe some more rummaging here in the future. All right, bye.